have a talent for observing nature? Do you enjoy studying organisms and ecosystems? Do you like doing field and lab experiments? Then you may find a career as a biologist to be a great environment for you. Biologists study living organisms in ecosystems to manage natural resources. They work in diverse fields, such as aquatic biology, marine biology, botany, environmental impact assessment, microbiology, land reclamation and remediation, wildlife management, and zoology. To observe the natural habitat of this career, we spoke to a biologist working in Alberta.
Hi, I'm Alex, and I'm a biologist. A biologist is someone who answers the question of what is life and where does life come from and how does life work. Biology is a pretty broad category that encompasses everything from the processes that happen within cells and then the processes that happen within populations and species and over large amounts of geological time. As far back as I can remember, I was turning over rocks and looking for critters. And when I was a little bit older, when I was in elementary school, I would be writing notes about observations of animals that I saw in my backyard and in the neighborhood. And so I always have been a naturalist in a lot of ways. If you're really interested in biology and you get an undergraduate degree in biology, you can then go and get a PhD or a master's degree in biology as well. And if you get a PhD in biology and you know you want to do research or teaching at a university someday, you could be a professor. That's the academic pathway. There are lots of other potential jobs that you can have. There's lots of industry positions in agriculture and biotechnology where you'd be either working in a laboratory or you'd be working doing data analysis as a big part of the job. You could be out camping in the desert or in the rainforest. Lots of different rugged terrain that you could be navigating. And so there's an adventure element to being a biologist as well. In order to call yourself a professional biologist, you have to be registered with the Alberta Society of Professional Biologists. In the winter time, my job is pretty straightforward. I generally catch up on emails is the first thing I do. After that, I'll do some writing. And then I will go into the lab generally and I will do some lab work. Dissections is a big part of what I do. I dissect honeybees. I extract the RNA out of the bees and then we quantify the amount of RNA for particular genes. It's our way of looking at how a particular gene is expressed in the bee. We wear lab coats, we wear gloves, we always wear closed-toed shoes. We have safety goggles and pants in the laboratory because there are sharp objects and there's chemicals. In the summer, that's our field season, we call it. That's when our honeybees are active, which are stinging insects. So the personal protective equipment we use is usually something over our face, a veil. I'd say our core responsibility is to uphold the values and ethics of being an accurate scientist and a true scientist. And then the next sort of layer of responsibility is to disseminate your findings to the public. And if what you're studying is something complicated and hard to understand for non-experts, part of your job is finding out how to communicate that to lay people in a way that they can understand, that they don't need to have all this background knowledge and understand all the jargon in order to understand what's going on.
This is a really undeveloped one. Yeah. This one's much more developed.
It's important to have a lot of different tools in your toolbox as a biologist. Effective communication. You have to be sort of statistically minded and mathematically minded in ways. Having fine motor skills is good. It's good to be able to use your fingers and make small, fine movements. You have to be interested in inquiry. You have to have a mind that is open to new ideas. You have to have a creativity. You have to come up with interesting questions, but then you also have to come up with effective ways to answer those questions. Questions about life. Fundamental questions about how life operates. The most satisfying part about being a biologist is that I get to ask weird questions and then I get to answer them and I get to actually work on ways to solve those bizarre questions. And it really being sort of surprising that someone's going to then pay you to do it.
Biologists have an inquisitive nature and are good at keeping accurate records. They also have a head for math and statistics. If you're open-minded, good at synthesizing data, and love the outdoors, research, and problem solving, then a career as a biologist may be in your nature. Synthesize the details of this career, including training requirements and salary ranges, by going to the occupational profile on the ALIS website. While you're there, check out some biodiverse occupations, including agrologist, biochemist, and biotechnologist. Explore the possibilities. Go to alice.alberta.ca.